Hey there, friend. Thanks for popping by. I am preaching in my, it's not mine yet. It's a new studio. I'm actually test driving this studio because our last one has 170,000 kilometers on it. I'm not sure if I'm going to buy this one. You let me know. If you feel an extra anointing on this message, maybe I will purchase this one. But anyways, I'm test driving this new studio, but I had a little scripture in my heart and a few thoughts, and I wanted to share it with you. Today, I want to talk about success. Not how to be successful, not what success is, but I want to talk about the greatest misconception that people have concerning success. And it's a misconception, it's a lie believed by about 99% of people, and it's a lie that keeps us from experiencing inner joy and lasting happiness and satisfaction. And I find that oftentimes a lie, when you believe a lie, if you can erase that lie, if you can get rid of that lie, what you'll find behind that lie is a truth that brings breakthrough in your life. And my prayer for you is that that is what's going to happen today in Jesus' name. So here's the misconception, the lie that I want to address today and hopefully erase from your mind if it's something that you've believed. And it's this: many people believe that on the other side of success is lasting joy, happiness, and fulfillment. Let me say it this way. People think that they'll be happy once they reach their goals. I want to tell you something. That is not the truth. I mean, reaching your goals has there is a moment of happiness. When you have a goal, that something that you're striving for, something that you're reaching for, you know what your goals are. There is a moment when you hit your goal and it's like, yes, I did it. But I think a lot of times we think that if I could just lose that 50 pounds, if I could just build that successful small business, if I could just win that girl's heart and get her to marry me, if I could just fill in the blank, maybe for you, success is winning that dance competition. Maybe for you, success is running your first marathon. And we have these goals, and that's wonderful. I have goals and dreams and things that I'm pursuing. But what many people believe is, while they're living through, many people live miserable lives, they're not happy, they're not satisfied, but they believe in their heart that once they reach their goal, once they're successful, then they'll be happy, then they'll be satisfied, then their life will be wonderful. And friend, it just isn't true. As I'm now getting into my 40s, I'm finding that a lot of the dreams that I had for my life are finally being fulfilled. In my 30s, it was just, I felt like striving, just, oh, I want to do this, I want to do that. I remember one of my dreams was to write, I had written this book that I wrote. Some of you guys have read it now, Access Granted. But I had a revelation that God gave me on the kingdom of God, and it was my desire to write this book that would just absolutely help people see the kingdom of God in a whole new way. And it is a bit of a theological shift for many people, but I wanted to do it in such a way, I wanted to write it in such a way that even a 14-year-old would read it, enjoy it, there would be a flow to it. And I spent years, literally years, writing and rewriting and rewriting this book, early mornings, late nights. And I remember thinking, one day when I fit, and I remember those miserable days, one day when I finish this book, oh, then I'll be happy. You know, you do that too. You know, you just think, one day, if I could just do this, then I'd be so. And I remember the day I finally finished the book. By the way, if you haven't got it, you can get it on our website or Amazon.com or Amazon.ca. Or if you don't want to spend the money, we still have the audio version for free on our website, oilpatchpulpit.com. Not for much longer. If you want it, you better get it quick. But you can still download the audio version for free on there. But I remember thinking, oh, if I could just get it done. I remember the day that it was finished and I got it in my hand. There it was. There was this moment of, yay, I did it. I did it. I did it. But what was shocking was how short-lived that happiness was. You know, it was a great day or maybe two. But then it was kind of this, okay, well, that's done. Now what am I going to do? What am I going to focus on? And I think a lot of times we just think that on the other side of our success is this beautiful place of ecstasy that just never ends. And you finally reach that goal and it's like, nope, life is still what it is, you know. Maybe your dream is to lose that 50 pounds, and you think, if I lost 50, boy, then I'd be happy. You work your butt off, hit that treadmill every day, and once you've lost the 50 pounds, guess what? You're still you. You may be a little skinnier version. Maybe you feel a little healthier. But a lot of people reach their goals, and they're still miserable. They're still depressed. In fact, some of the most successful people in the world are some of the most depressed people in the world. Why? Because success doesn't bring with it happiness. You think even money, if I could just save $1 million, then I'd be happy. I can promise you, I know lots of millionaires. Money doesn't make you happy. One of my dreams was to build a successful multi-million dollar company. I thought, once I did that, oh, then I'd be happy. Well, we did it. We built a wonder. In fact, now we have a few businesses and starting another one next month. God's blessed us. We've found what we might call success in the business arena, but does it make you happy? No, it's work. It's getting up early. It's staffing issues. It's, you know, in the old days, I had bills that were $1,000. Now I have bills that are $100,000. It comes with it. Success comes with it. So many other challenges and trials and difficulties. And so this idea that if I'm successful, I will be happy, I promise you, it's a lie. Now, I'm not saying this because I don't want you to pursue success. I want you to fulfill your dreams. I want you to lose that 50 pounds. I promise you, you'll be happier if you lose the 50 than if you gain 50 more. Okay, so there's a little happiness. But I don't want you to think that happiness is on the other side of success. Because when you do that, you put off happiness for 5 years, and then 10 years, and then 20 years. You get to the top of a mountain, you reach your goal, and you're still not happy. So what do? You pick a higher mountain, and you climb that ladder, and you get to the top of that ladder, and you're still not happy. So what do? You pick another ladder. And one day, you're laying on your deathbed, thinking back about your life, realizing I spent my whole life pursuing happiness, and I never got there. I reached all these goals, but I was never happy. Why? Because happiness is not the result of reaching your goals. Happiness is the result of reaching the Lord. I'm going to say that again. Happiness is the result of reaching the Lord. Happiness, inner fulfillment, satisfaction, what you and I really are after in this life, that inner, I'm happy, I'm joyous, that fullness, that's the word, fullness of joy. What we're hungry for, you can't get it by reaching goals, by saving money, by starting businesses. You're not going to get that because you finally marry that girl or marry that guy or whatever your dreams may be. It only comes from connecting with Jesus Christ. Here's the scripture for today. It's David, who was a very successful man. He beat Goliath. He became king. He was rich as you can ever imagine. But you know what? He never got his happiness and his fulfillment, his internal fulfillment from outward success. Where did he say he got his happiness from? Listen to this. This is Psalm 16:11. He says, he's talking to the Lord. He says, "For in your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore." David found pleasure, satisfaction, joy in being in the presence of the Lord. You know, the most important thing I ever do every day is just spend time with God. Park out in a field in a pickup truck and just love Him and worship Him and tell Him how wonderful He is. And I'll meditate on some scriptures and I'll sing a little song, and then maybe I'll preach to you for a few minutes. But that time alone pursuing Him, that's what fills me with joy. I still pursue success. I'm still after stuff. Right now, I'm actually on my own little weight loss journey. 61 days ago, I had a big gut because I was lazy all summer. And I set a goal that I'm going to lose this gut. I'm going to lose this weight. I'm going to run 5 kilometers every single day. And I'm going to do it for 90 days without a day off. Well, let me tell you something. 61 days later, I've done it. I've run 5K every day. I've lost 26 pounds. My gut is gone. I still got 29 more days. Who knows? I might even have a six-pack by the time this is over. But you know, my gut's gone. And I remember thinking even then, like, oh, if I could just lose this gut, oh, then. And you know what I've realized as I'm finding success in my weight loss is it's not making me happy. Success is work. It's getting up in the morning. It's sweating on the treadmill. I don't enjoy this. I'm not having fun with this. I don't get happy and satisfied from being successful. I'm still going to pursue success. I'm still going to try to reach my goals. I'm going to do that. But I don't look to those things for inner joy. I look to the Lord for that. And so you can be happy, and you can be happy today. And that's what I'm trying to get to. All that to say this, don't put happiness off to that one day, someday, when I achieve that goal, then I'll be happy. No, you've got to choose to go and get your joy today, to go and get your happiness today. And where is it? In His presence is fullness of joy. At His right hand are pleasures forevermore. God bless you for taking 10, 12 minutes to listen to this episode. That's you pursuing the Lord, seeking. I encourage you, now take another 10 minutes, take another 20 minutes, go park somewhere, or go find a quiet place and just draw close to the Lord. Spend some time with Him. That's what's going to fill you with joy. That's where you're going to find fullness. God bless you. I hope that was a blessing to you. We'll see you soon.